Okay, in this video, I want to do a couple examples. The first one here says, given the figure, find alpha and beta. And the figure here is basically a 3, 4, 5 right triangle. But this time we want to find the angles. Okay, so let's start with alpha. Looking at alpha and the side opposite measures 3 units, and the side adjacent measures 4 units. So I'm thinking opposite over adjacent. What comes to mind? Well, tangent, right? Tangent of an angle is opposite over adjacent. So with that, I can write tangent of alpha is 3/4. Okay, we're after the angle alpha, so what I'm going to do is apply tangent inverse to both sides. In that case, I'll have alpha equals tangent inverse of 3/4. Remember, tangent inverse returns an angle. And so I can do that on a calculator. Tangent inverse of 3/4, well, that comes out to about 36.9 degrees, approximately. All right, so we found alpha, now we're going to find beta. Certainly we can use geometry, all the angles have to add up to 180, that would be pretty easy. But in this problem, I want to use trig. So now I'm looking at angle B. Right? And so the side opposite angle B is 4 units, and the side adjacent is 3 units. So we'll use tangent again, and we can write tangent of beta equals, in this case, 4/3, right? Opposite over adjacent. And so beta equals tangent inverse of 4/3, or beta is approximately equal to, using a calculator, tan inverse of 4/3. Right, and I get 53.1 degrees. And that was the goal. They wanted us to find angle beta and angle alpha. And we have it. All right, so let's do another one. Okay, so here we have a figure, and push it up a little bit. They want us to find the sides this time, x and y, given one of the angles here at 72 degrees. Okay, so I'm going to look at 72 degrees, and I can see that the length of the side opposite is given. And I want to find x, so I'm thinking opposite over adjacent again. So to do that, I'm going to use tangent. And so I can write tangent of 72 degrees is equal to 10.5 centimeters over x, right? Now, once I have that set up, I need to solve then for x. Using algebra, I'm going to cross multiply. I'm going to try to isolate x. So x times tangent of 72 degrees equals 10.5. Dividing both sides by tangent of 72, we get x equals 10.5 divided by tangent of 72 degrees. Okay, so once we have that, we can do that on a calculator. And I'm going to make use of my fraction button. 10.5. Whoops, let's do that again. 10.5 divided by tangent of 72 degrees. All right, so on a calculator, I could see that's approximately 3.4. Now, that's not an angle, right? That's the length of the side that's unknown. And the unit here is centimeters. All right, so we found x. Okay, so now the goal is to find y. Again, the side opposite is 10.5, but now the unknown is the hypotenuse. So opposite and hypotenuse, what comes to mind? Well, sine, right? Sine is defined to be opposite over hypotenuse. Right? So we can write sine of 72 degrees is equal to 10.5 divided by y, right? Opposite over hypotenuse this time. Okay, so now we'll solve for y, cross multiplying. Y times sine of 72 degrees equals 10.5. And then dividing by sine of 72, we get y equals 10.5 divided by sine of 72. And so y is approximately equal to, on a calculator, 10.5 divided by sine of 72. Yeah. And that comes out to approximately 11.0. And again, that was a length, right, of the hypotenuse measured in centimeters in this particular example. Okay, so a little bit different than the last one. The last one wanted us to find the angles, so we had to use the inverse functions to do that. Here they wanted us to find the sides. Once we set it up, we just use algebra from there. Okay, so that's to get you going on the rest of section 1.4.